We give them a sense of belonging, a sense of being wanted, a sense of security.
The Opportunity Youth Initiative is a program that we started 2 years ago, really in the middle of a pandemic, where we were trying to find a way to help those youth, 16 to 24, find employment.
I was once that child, you know what I mean? Once that person, you know what I mean, who didn't have that person, you know what I mean, to pat you on your back saying, good job.
Mr. Lewis, you know, he's like a big brother figure to me, or like kind of like an uncle, because, you know, even when I'm wrong, he'll try and correct me, or if I need a little bit of guidance because I'm struggling somewhere, he'll help me with that.
They always listen to me, and it's super cool that they listen and are there for me.
Just know that, you know, we make a difference. Yeah. Just the opportunity that was not afforded to me. These streamlined programs into a career weren't around when I was coming up. So to come from the life that I came from and to be able to come back to my community after so much, and I'm not even ashamed to say after 20 years of incarceration, you know, for mistakes that I made when I was younger, and be able to come back to the same communities that I terrorized or helped tear down, and now I get to help build them up. So I understand that it starts with the youth. It starts with the youth. Can't give up on them.
I've never been the type of person to like sit behind a desk. Like I mean, I don't know if you guys can tell, but I got ADHD. Like even in there, I just got a whole bunch of energy. So, I mean, it's good to take that energy and use it in a productive and destructive way. Cause in construction, you also do demolition. So, and I mean, my mom's always told me I'm good at breaking things. So,
this is definitely a good career, not just a job. Like, yeah, you make good money and that's cool or whatever, but you could go anywhere in the United States or really anywhere in the world, and there's always going to be construction work.
For the last 11 weeks, I've been learning how to use my tape measure, and then on top of that, I've been learning how to use my speed square leveler and learning all the parts about framing and how to like install doors and windows and stuff like that. So we built a tiny house, and we built a couple of trusses for the roof, and then we built foundation and did the floor, walls, and insulation.
I learned a lot more than I thought I would learn, because I learned math. Actually, I don't like math, but I learned math, so that was also really cool.
I want to be a laborer first off because they do everything. You know, they help with plumbers, they help with electricians, they help all that. So I figure if I learn how to do like small parts of each and every trade, I can apply that to what I need to build my house or like what I need in order to do maintenance to it. My future dreams, I also plan on building my own house with my dad and brother.
You know, when you look at the data, it really shows that there's residents of King County that have been hurt disproportionately throughout the pandemic. People of color, communities of color, those that are lower income. This program is specifically designed to help those people and give them a foot up.
It helps young people, not just minorities, get into construction fields, which are hard to get into.
I think it really helps to address some of the inequities that we have in King County and in all of our communities, and that's what the port's really working on these days.